I always have this mess of shoes behind my back door, so I'd make a boot nook in the wall right about here. So let's have a look at what's behind where those shoes are. That would be right here, so I have to get rid of some of this stuff here. I want to cut an opening that goes from about here all the way to here. So to figure out where this is going to be on the other side, I'm going to use a stack of rare earth magnets, and I'm just going to clamp them into the corner of what will be my opening. And from the other side, I'm just going to use a compass to figure out where those magnets are. And in the vertical direction, they're right about here. A problem with the walls in this house is they're the old plaster wall, almost an inch thick, and they have masonry in them, so I need a masonry blade to cut this open. I put a masonry blade on this old skill saw here, and I made this thing here for catching the dust. So with the blade guard all the way up, I just need to duct tape this on here. Here's what the old plaster walls are made out of. First, there's a thin layer of gypsum lath, then a layer of mortar on top, and then on top of that, another layer of gypsum, and then the paint. It's pretty sturdy stuff. You don't accidentally go through that with an elbow or a foot. Demolition complete. Now I can start to build that actual boot nook. It turns out my hole wasn't quite wide enough, so I had to chip out a bit more, and I still have to cut out a few corners here and here so I can bring this forward because I want this edge flush with this. That's getting better now. I'm just painting this box before installing it. Much easier this way. So I've got the boot nook screwed in place, and some of you are probably wondering, why is one side at an angle? It's so I can get this dryer vent pipe a little bit better if I need to. Very important, those boards that I knocked out were actually the thing that's holding up the landing, so I added this board here and I screwed it in at an angle so it really pulls up on it so I have support again. I I put a little bit of caulking on the back of this just to help glue it on. And now placing it on there. I'm only going to nail it to the front edge.
A masonry blade is really not the best way to cut tiles, but I already had it in the saw, so I figured I might as well use it.
So the reason I've got this odd cuts in the tiles for the back is because I'm using up some old scraps. And I'm just going to glue these down with some caulking because nobody's going to walk on these tiles anyway, so I just need something to stick them down. Now, grout is much easier to work with than caulking. It's much less messy. But I'm just going to use caulking instead of grout. So the problem with caulking is the more you work it, the worse it looks, so I'll just leave it at that. I already went through plenty of paper towel just working this stuff, cleaning it up. Got the trim painted and now it's all done. It was a lot of work for room for three pairs of shoes, but then again,